when I first moved here, in the States, I had an amazing surgeon, I had an amazing neuro-oncologist, and I wanted to find somebody similar. So I called Cancer Care, which is the really only cancer treatment place in Canada, especially for brain cancer. And I wanted to talk to a doctor. Like, oh, well, no, we'll just talk to the nurse. I'm like, no, I want to talk to the doctor. They're like, okay. And because I also wanted to explain to him, like, very sort of doctory, because the treatment that I was doing was not an accepted treatment here in Canada. And I wanted to make sure that I'd be able to continue with it. And so I talked to this one doctor, and he didn't really, felt like he didn't really want to listen to my ideas. And I said, okay, can I talk to the nurse again? And I talked to her. I said, she goes, well, you don't. I said, I don't want him to be my doctor. She said, well, you don't really have a choice. And I said, I don't want him to be my doctor. I'll make a big fuss every time I come to Cancer Care if he's my doctor. She said, okay, we have somebody else that we can let you talk to. And he was on the phone with me forever, and I sent him all the articles about the treatment that I was on, the peer-reviewed articles about the different kind of the treatment I was doing and how it had been proven to be useful and helpful and have a longer lifespan after you did this treatment. If you did it at the same time as you did radiation, then you have to change your chemotherapy. So anyway, so then they didn't know that that was a good thing to do. But now they're saying, yes, what you guys did then is what we do for everybody now. So, and he did it, like, he was the person that did it for me, you know. So what I feel is most important is that they make eye contact with you and they listen, and they don't interrupt. And when I'm waiting in line to go see the doctor for an hour, 2 hours, I know that he's doing the exact same thing with somebody else. And I love that because he's not, have to go. It's like, I know that he is spending time with the person that needs that time. And so when he comes into me, if I have a ton of questions, I'll be like, I have a lot of questions. Can you get through them quickly? And he's like, yeah, I think so. Because I know that sometimes I have really important questions. So if I have a really important question, I need him to stay. Sometimes I'm like, I just have random questions that I wanted to ask you, but if you're too busy, we can do it another time. But he'll be like, no, we can do it. He pays attention. He cares. And it's just, I feel super fortunate. And he's really interested in research and finding a cure.